In this lesson, we are going to learn communication satellites. And after the lesson, you are going to be able to describe the use and role of satellites in communication. Also, you are going to know the relative merits of both geostationary and polar orbiting satellites. First of all, why do we need satellite communication? We need satellite communication because we need effective long-distance communication. Do we have problem with long-distance communication? Yes. For the long-distance communication, we are using skywaves and surface waves, but they are ineffective. Why they are ineffective? Because this is the Earth's surface, for example. Here we have a transmitter. It transmits the signals. This is the ionosphere, and the signals are reflecting from the ionosphere, and they are reflecting back to the receiver. This is the receiver, and this is the transmitter. And sometimes the waves are sent to the surface, and then they are moving to the ionosphere, and then they reflect from the surface again, and then they move from the they move to the ionosphere, and then reflect back to the receiver. So these are called also the surface waves. This type of communication is a little bit ineffective when compared to the satellite communication. And the bandwidths that are available are narrow for sky waves and for surface waves. I mean, in radio communication, the bandwidths are narrow. And also, the bandwidths available for the medium waves and for short waves are already crowded. Many stations, many broadcasting systems are now using medium wavelength and short wavelength. That's why it is crowded at the moment. That's why we need new methods. What is satellite communication? Here we have a transmitter. The signals from the transmitter are sent to the satellite, and satellite send the signals back to the receiver on the Earth. So this type of communication is more effective when compared to the sky wave or ground wave communication. Here the signals are sent upward to the satellites are called uplink, and those are sent back to the receiver are called downlink. Okay, downlink. Why satellite communication? It enables more wave bands to be made available at much higher frequencies. So in the case of satellite communication, we have more wave bands, and also we can communicate with higher frequencies, and the data capacity is much more high. And also the carrier waves frequencies up and down are different, so that signal received from Earth is not swamped by the signal that is transmitted back to the Earth. If you have a transmitter, this is the transmitter on the Earth, and we send signals to the satellite is here, and then this is uplink, then this satellite distribute the signals to the different stations on Earth. And since the uplink frequencies are different from downlink frequencies, there is no interference of the signals. As you know, when waves encounter, there is superposition of the waves, there is interference of the waves. For example, if one wave, this is a one wave, I mean one pulse, and this is another pulse, if they move toward each other, when they meet completely, when they overlap, so we get a higher amplitude for one moment. In this case, for example, if you have such two pulses, when they meet somewhere here, and they are going to destroy each other, and for one moment we will not have any waves. That's why no interference takes place, since the upward frequencies and downward frequencies are different from each other. The upward and downward frequencies are ranged, for example, for the upward frequencies they are 6 gigahertz, and downward frequencies are 4 gigahertz, or 14 to 11 gigahertz, or 30 to 20 gigahertz. They are different from each other. What are the advantages of satellites? The satellite to satellite communication is very precise, and the coverage area of satellite is very high when it is compared to the terrestrial system. And theoretically, 3 geostationary satellites provides 100% Earth coverage. Okay, if you, for example, have 3 satellites, each of them are 120 degree. Okay, if you have 3 satellites in the orbit like this, they are going to send signals to the Earth surface. This satellite is going to cover 120 degree, and this is going to cover 120 degree, and this is going to cover the other 120 degree. So theoretically, three satellites are enough to broadcast or to send signals to all of the surface of the Earth. What are the disadvantages? They are costly to launching satellites into orbit is costly. And there is a large propagation delay in satellite communication than in the terrestrial communication. What does it mean? For example, the signal delay approximately is 480 milliseconds for geostationary orbit. What's happening is something like this. This is the Earth surface, and assume the satellite is somewhere here. The signal is sent to the satellite, and then the satellite sends it back to the Earth. So this takes some time, and there is some delay in the signal when you are communicating. If this is a geostationary satellite, I will explain it in next slides, what is geostationary orbit. So there is approximately 480 milliseconds time delay in communication. So a question arises, how do satellites stay in orbit around the Earth? This is the Earth. And assume now satellite is orbiting around the Earth in a circular orbit, and this is Earth. Assume the satellite is somewhere here. When satellite is sent to the orbit, it is given an initial velocity, velocity v, and there is gravitational force between Earth and the satellite. This is force F. If the satellite does not move, if it is stationary here, the gravitational force is going to pull it to the Earth. But since it is moving in a circular path, this force toward the center of the Earth is always changing the direction of the velocity. It is always changing the direction of the velocity. Initially, it was moving in that direction. Now it is moving in this direction. And at this position, it is moving in this direction. So always the force F, I mean the gravitational force, is perpendicular to the velocity, and it always changes the direction of the velocity. So the satellites cannot escape from the orbit, and it revolve around Earth in a circular orbit. So what are the types of satellites? We have weather satellites. Meteorologists use them. We have communication satellites. We use them for phone calling. And there is broadcast satellites. We are receiving television signals. And there is scientific satellites, for example, Hubble Space Telescope. And there is navigational satellites. It helps ships and planes to navigate. And there is Earth observation satellites. They are observing our planet from temperature to the pressure. And there is also military satellites. Now, what are the components of a satellite? There are three main components of a satellite. First component is the communication system. It includes the antennas and transponders. The transponders receive and transmit signals. The second component is the power system. This includes the solar panels that provide power. They receive the solar energy and then transmit to the electricity. And then there is a repulsion system. This system includes some rockets to propel the satellite. If we want to change the direction of the satellite or the orbit of the satellite, these rockets are used. What happens to the satellite when it is no longer functional? Okay, so when it is no longer functional, it is sent to the graveyard orbit. This is the Earth. And this is, for example, original orbit of the satellite. Okay, it is moving in this orbit. It is rotating in this orbit. But once it is no longer functional, its power system is used. I mean, the one that I explained here, the repulsion system is used. And this repulsion system is now, for example, it is moving in this orbit. When the repulsion system is used, its orbit is now changed to another orbit. I mean, it is changed to the graveyard. I'm sorry, it is changed to the graveyard orbit. Now it is going to move in another orbit. Once, initially it was moving in this orbit. Now when some extra energy is given to the satellite, it is moved to another orbit. And in this orbit, it rotates without functioning. Why satellites are covered with gold-colored foil? There are two main reasons. First of all, there is huge temperature variation in space from 150 to negative 150 centigrade degrees to 200 centigrade degrees. So we need to cover the satellites with some materials to resist the temperature change. Also, there is solar radiation from the sun, and they can damage the satellites. That's why this gold colored foil also prevent the damage from the solar radiation. There are mainly two types of satellites. There are more, but we are going to concentrate on two of them: geostationary and polar satellites. Sorry. What is geostationary orbit? GEO. The satellites are in orbit approximately 35,000 kilometers above the Earth's surface, and they are along the equator. And the objects in geostationary orbit revolve around the Earth at the same speed as the Earth rotates. So the Earth itself is rotating. Earth itself is rotating. If the satellite is somewhere here, the period of rotation of the Earth and the period of rotation of the satellites are equal to each other. Their angular speeds are equal to each other. It means Earth is rotating in every 24 hours. The GEO satellites also rotate every 24 hours. They are always looking at the same point on the surface. I'm sorry. Okay. The GEO satellite's distance from Earth gives it a large coverage area, almost a fourth of the Earth's surface. This is the Earth, and they are far away from the Earth, so they cover a large proportion of the Earth's surface. They can broadcast, they can send signals to this portion of the Earth. And the GEO satellites have 24-hour view of particular area. If this is the satellite, they can always 24 hours they can view this area. I mean, send the signals and receive signals from this area. And that's why they are very important for broadcasting. I mean, for television signals, we use GEO satellites. Geostationary satellites' distance causes it to have both comparatively weak signal and time delay in the signal, since they are a little bit away, about 35,000 kilometers above the surface of the Earth. Okay, so when you send a signal to the satellite, the signal gets weaker and weaker, and when it sent back to the surface again, because of the air molecules, there is attenuation of the waves, so signal becomes weaker, and there is also some time delay in the signals. Geostationary satellites centered above the equator, they have difficulty broadcasting signals to near polar regions. So if this is our Earth, for example, the satellite is somewhere here, and these are the poles of the Earth. Earth is rotating. The signals from the satellite to the surface of the Earth to the equator, no problem, but signals to the poles is very, very difficult. Okay. What about the polar satellites? Their period is about 100 minutes, approximately 1.5 hours. They rotate around the Earth every 100 minutes approximately. Their height changes between 700 kilometers to 800 kilometers, and that's why there is no phone delay in the phone conversation. We do not notice it, and generally we use these kind of satellites, polar satellite, for example, for mapping, for example, for weather forecasting, and for global positioning systems. And let's continue with the polar satellites. Continuous communication with a single polar satellite is not possible. Let me explain the polar satellite a little bit more in detail. Here is Earth, and here are the poles of the Earth, and the satellite is, let me change the color, it will be better. The satellite is revolving around the Earth from pole to pole. Okay, not around the equator. This is the equator, but it revolves around the Earth from pole to pole, and the Earth is rotating around this axis. Let me change my color once more. This is the axis of rotation. This is the axis of rotation of the Earth. The Earth is rotating, and this is the satellite moving around the Earth from pole to pole. So the Earth is moving beneath the satellite. I mean, since the period is approximately 1.5 hour, in every 1.5 hour, it rotates around the Earth. But Earth is revolving beneath the satellite, so in every 1.5 hour, it can take signals from all over the surface of the Earth. But if you want to send signals to only one particular area of the Earth, since the Earth is moving, the satellite is always in this orbit, this point on the Earth is going to move sometimes later, and then when it is on the other side, It cannot take signal from the satellite. That's why we need many satellites. If we are going to use polar satellites for communication, we need a lot of satellites to get a continuous communication. So they don't have a fixed position relative to the Earth's surface. They are visible between 15 to 20 minutes during each pass. And they have a small area of coverage because they are not very far away from the surface of the Earth, about 700 kilometers. And the atmospheric drag affects polar satellites, causing gradually orbital deterioration. If they are not very far away, they are rotating like this from pole to pole, and there is the atmosphere. The atmosphere gradually decreases from the surface up to 100 kilometers above the surface of the Earth. So actually, these polar satellites are moving inside the atmosphere. They collide with the air molecules. Even though at high amplitudes there is little air, but after revolving several years, the effect of drag of air becomes visible. So they have better signal strength because they are closer to the Earth, and they have less time delay, as I explained. So what orbit should be chosen for the satellite? It completely depends on the purpose of the usage. If you are going to, for example, use the satellites for broadcasting, you should use a geostationary satellite. I mean, it should rotate around the Earth, and it is about 35,000 kilometers above the Earth, and it's going to its angular velocity is going to be equal to the angular velocity of the Earth. So if you are going to use a satellite for the broadcasting, you should use a geostationary satellite. But for example, if you are going to use one for weather condition, so if in this case you are going to use a polar satellite, and this is going to be its orbit, it's going to move from pole to pole, and the Earth is going to move under the satellite, and the satellite is going to sweep the Earth's surface every 1.2 hours, and it can get information from the temperature, pressure, and humidity, and other factors of the air. Okay, thank you for listening. See you next time.